Hello everyone, I welcome you all in our next series of video lecture. I am Anish Vora and today we will study about design of AC machine. Design of AC machine. In case of design of AC machine, we are currently working on three-phase induction motor. And our today's topic is estimation of main dimension. Main dimensions are D and L, that is diameter of stator core, and L, that is length of stator core. In last lecture, we had discussed about how to calculate our main dimension, that is estimation of the main dimension, and last time we had considered the ratio of L by tau. Tau is a pawl pitch and L length of stator core. This ratio can be utilized to separate D and L. Now in today's lecture we'll study how to separate D and L if the ratio is not given. For example, now we discussed about peripheral speed. Suppose peripheral speed is given. In case of peripheral speed, we know the equation, that peripheral speed or peripheral velocity, that is pi, D and Ns. So D, that is our diameter, and Ns, that is our speed in revolution per second. From this equation, if peripheral speed is available, then from the given data, we can easily calculate our diameter D, that is peripheral speed divided by pi divided by speed revolution per second. So we have to use this equation. So now let us start calculation of one of the numerical, right? So we start with given data. So given data, we have, suppose, 30 kilowatt three-phase induction motor ...400 volt, 50 hertz, speed is 1440 rpm. This much of data is given. Now efficiency 87%, power factor 0.9, lagging. In case of induction motor, normally we have lagging power factor. Winding factor KW 0.955. If it is not given, we can always assume winding factor as 0.955. Specific magnetic loading is given 0.5 Weber per meter square, and specific electric loading, that is given 30,000 ampere meter. One other data, that is peripheral speed, is given as 20 meter per second. So this much of data is given, and we need to calculate main dimension. Last time we discussed that we have to follow total 5 steps to estimate our main dimension. So today also we'll follow same 5 steps, right? Step 1, that is to calculate KVA. To calculate KVA rating. Normally, in case of induction motor, either rating is given in kilowatt or it is given in horsepower, HP. So, in first step, we have to convert always into KVA, because in our output equation, we take Q and Q is our KVA rating. So, we know that how to calculate KVA rating. So, kilowatt divided by power factor and efficiency. So, therefore, Q is equal to, we have 30 kilowatt, power factor is given 0.9, and efficiency is 87%. So, now let us calculate. So, 30 kilowatt divided by 0.9 divided by 0.87. So, it comes to 38.32. Now it is in KVA. So, now KVA rating is available. This is our first step. So, KVA rating is available. So, same way we have to go to the second step. Now we have second step. Step number 2. That is to calculate speed in RPS, revolutions per second. This is our second step. Now, one thing you always remember, that while calculating revolution per second, we have to consider always synchronous speed. In case of induction motor, we have to always consider synchronous speed, right? So, we have been given 440 RPM, that is not the synchronous speed, that is the rotor speed. So, synchronous speed, right? So, we have to calculate based on the number of poles. So, ultimately, synchronous speed, that is 1500 RPM, and therefore, synchronous speed in revolution per second, that is 1500 divided by 60, and then it comes to 25 RPS. So, now, this is our step number 2. So, we have calculated revolutions per second. Now, step number 3. Step number 3. That is to calculate output coefficient. Output coefficient is CO. We know the equation. That is 1.11 pi square BAV, that is specific magnetic loading. AC, that is specific electric loading. Winding factor, multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3. Now let us substitute all the values. 1.11 multiplied by 3.14 square multiplied by specific magnetic loading. 9.55, that is our winding factor. We have 30 multiplied by 10 raised to 3, that is our specific electric loading, and multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3. So if we discard 10 raised to 3 and 10 raised to minus 3, then we can easily calculate our output coefficient. So it is 1.11 multiplied by 3.14 square multiplied by 0.5 multiplied by 0.955 multiplied by 30. Then it comes to 156.78. So this is our step number 3. We have calculated output coefficient, that is CO. So now let us go towards our step number 4. In normally total 5 steps, we can easily estimate or we can easily calculate our main dimensions. So step number 4, that is to calculate volume, to calculate volume, right? So output equation we know, that QO, CO, that is output coefficient, D square L, and revolution per second, that is our speed. So D square L, product of D square L, normally in meter cube, that is known as the volume of the machine. So D square L is equal to Q divided by CO and divided by a revolution per speed. So Q, now KVA rating we have calculated, that is 38.32 divided by KVA rating, that is 156.78, and revolution per second, that is 25. So D square L, now we can calculate D square L, that is 38.32 divided by 156.78 divided by 25. So it comes to 978 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3. And that is always in meter cube. So we have calculated volume. So this is our volume of the machine. So our next step, step number 5, that is to separate D and L. Normally we have to follow these 5 steps to estimate mean dimension, to separate D and L. Now the change in this design numerical is ratio of L by tau is not given, hence we have to take peripheral speed. Peripheral speed is given, that is VA, and that is 20 meter per second. So this data is given, peripheral speed is given, right? So from this given data, VA, that is pi, D and NS, and therefore D is equal to VA divided by pi and NS. So 20 divided by 3.14 and multiply multiplied by 25. Therefore, D is equal to, now D is available. Diameter is directly available in this type of numerical design. So 20 divided by 3.14 divided by 25. So it comes to 0.254. 0.255, let us take 5 in meter, right? Diameter is always in meter. So now diameter is available. So if diameter is available, we have to calculate length. So we have already calculated d square l, that is 9.78 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3, right? So we have to substitute value of d into this equation. So let us substitute value of d into d square l. So therefore l is equal to 9.78 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3 divided by d square. So 9.78 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3 d square. So 0.255 square. So ultimately it comes to 9.78 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3 and 0.255 square. So it comes to 0.065. And therefore, let us now calculate L. 9.78 divided by 0.065. So it comes to 0.15. So L is always in meter. So now we have calculated L. So ultimately, and therefore main dimension, D and L both are available, 0.255 meter and L, that is 0.15 meter. So this data is available. So now we have estimated our main dimension for a 30 kilowatt three-phase induction motor. Same way, we will continue our calculations and keep watching my videos. Thank you very much.